promote a culture of being socially responsible among budding managers and the importance of giving back to the society. Through our work, we strive to reinforce GIM's educational philosophy of producing individuals that are ethical, socially responsible, and humane. Today, we have with us Mr. George Abraham, along with Mr. Mendoza, Mr. Ma, Mr. Tahir, and Ms. Gauri Priya. Mr. Abraham has worked in the field of sales and advertising with companies like Ogilvy Benson and Macro for nearly 10 years. He was elected as an Ashoka Fellow in 2001 and was also awarded the Sanskriti Award in 1994. He is known to have set up the World Blind Cricket Council in 1996 and was its founding president. He also launched the first ever World Cup of Cricket for the Blind in 1998. Mr. Abraham ran the Olympic torch at Atlanta in 1996 and helped set up the Low Vision Center at the Dr. Shroff's charity Eye Hospital in 2000. He will be speaking to us on the topic, Life Never Stops Because of Challenges, The Show Must Go On. He will be touching upon how the corporate world can be sensitized towards physically challenged employees and how one can succeed in life even in adverse circumstances. We are privileged to have you all here with us today. I would now like to call upon our director, Professor Dilima, to share a few words with us and welcome Mr. Abraham to Momentum from our side.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
You must be wondering, people, when they meet me first time, they ask me, this is trip number one to Goa. Let me tell you, this is trip number six to Goa. Okay. Let's begin. I would like you all to take a deep breath. Breathe in and breathe out. breathe in again and then close your eyes. And just imagine that you are inside an aircraft, taking off from the Goa airport, and you are headed over the Arabian Sea towards, where does the Arabian Sea take you to?
West.
Towards the west, yeah. So you're heading westwards, right? And you're flying at about 36,000 feet, and suddenly the aircraft starts rocking. Now moving to the left, moving to the right, going up and down, your heavy lunch is kind of shaking inside, and suddenly you hear the voice of the captain, who says, "Ladies and gentlemen, we have hit turbulent weather, but not to worry, things are under control. This will last about 45 minutes. Just sit tight on your seats, fasten your seat belts. Things should be okay." So you breathe a sigh of relief and you hang on. And suddenly he comes back on the line again. And he says, "Gentlemen and ladies, I want to tell you, by the way, I happen to be blind." So what do you think would be your reaction in that kind of a situation? Any ideas? I hope you're not holding your breath still. What do you think you guys would feel? Some of you would be panicking. Some of you would be saying your prayers. Some of you would be feeling the life jacket below the seat. Some of them would be asking the air hostess, "Where is the parachute?" And so on and so forth. But the fact of the matter is, ladies and gentlemen, that in 2004, a blind gentleman from London flew a plane from London to Sydney and landed safely with no problems. Because most of our flights now are computer driven. And as things have evolved over the last 30 years, I feel in the next 10, 15 years, you just might have blind pilots flying aircrafts. And initially there might be nerves, but otherwise it'll be okay. Because I still remember when the first woman pilot took over Indian Airlines. I still remember there were a couple of guys who immediately said, the moment they heard the lady's voice saying, "I'm the captain," they got up and said, "Let me have my refund." But the interesting thing is, today, I have been on a flight on Indigo where the captain, the co-captain, as well as the entire crew were all ladies. And the landing was extremely smooth. So, it's a question of technology, it's a question of training, and as you go along. So possibilities are tremendous. I would also like to tell you about the year, I think it's 2004, when there were illegal arms dropped at Puralia in West Bengal. Do you remember reading this?
Yes.
And a British pilot was arrested and put behind bars. Tony Blair sent his home minister to India to negotiate his release. And when he was in India, the British Council had organized a talk, a public address at the British Council Library on Rasul Gandhi Road in New Delhi. And I happened to be at that event. Mr. David Plunkett, who was the Home Secretary under Tony Blair, happened to be totally blind. He was totally blind from the age of 7. And he had risen through school, college, through politics, elections, member of parliament, and then member of the government as a minister. So anything is really possible. And what I'd like to do right now is to share a short video with you. This video is part of a television serial that we had produced recently called Nazar Ya Nazariya. Who's helping here?
शिक्षा हर बच्चे का अधिकार है, ऐसा सिर्फ मैं नहीं कह रहा, हमारा संविधान भी कहता है। एजुकेशन या तालीम का अगर सिर्फ ये काम होता कि आप दो चार अल्फाज पढ़ जाएं, ये या वो साइंस की इक्वेशन समझ जाएं, तो शायद स्कूलिंग की इतनी अहमियत ही नहीं होती। पढ़ाई लिखाई और स्कूल के एक्सपोजर से हमें कुछ बनने की प्रेरणा मिलती है, साथ में अपने सपने या गोल्स पूरे करने की क्षमता मिलती है, और इन सबसे बड़ी चीज बराबरी का दर्जा। नजर या नजरिया के इस एपिसोड में देखते हैं एजुकेशन की बदौलत बदली हुई जिंदगियां।
मेरी रिसर्च के दौरान किसी ने मुझसे सवाल किया है ब्लाइंड स्कूल होता क्या है, तमाम कई तरह के ख्याल आ गए, क्या दृष्टिहीन बच्चों की एजुकेशन नहीं चलो होती है। किसी ने तो ये भी पूछा कि दृष्टिहीन बच्चों को पढ़ाने लिखाने की क्या जरूरत है। खैर, ऐसे सवालों के जवाब मुझे तीन खास लोगों से मिले, एक सीनियर एडिटर, एक ऐसा प्रोफेशनल और एक अपने शहर के बहुत बड़े कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट फाउंडर। आंध्र प्रदेश के छोटे से गांव से लंदन स्कूल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स तक पढ़ने जाना, हिंदुस्तान के लीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर के सीनियर एडिटर की पोस्ट, किसी भी इंसान के लिए आम अचीवमेंट्स नहीं है। और इस जबरदस्त सफर के लिए मैं सुब्रमण्यम के पास सिर्फ एक ही था, एजुकेशन।
जब किसी फैमिली या कम्युनिटी में कोई डिसेबल्ड बच्चा होता है और आप उसे अच्छा एजुकेशन नहीं दे पाते तो आप उसकी विकलांगता को और बढ़ा देते हैं, उसे ज़्यादा विकलांग बना देते हैं। मेरे माँ बाप ने मुझे हमेशा प्रोत्साहित किया और मेरे एजुकेशन को हमेशा बढ़ावा दिया। एक वक्त था जब लोगों ने उनसे कहा कि मुझे उच्च शिक्षा देने में कोई समझदारी नहीं है। ग्रेजुएशन लोयला कॉलेज से किया था और उसके बाद JNU गया जो कि ह्यूमैनिटीज और दूसरे सब्जेक्ट्स के लिए काफ़ी जानी मानी यूनिवर्सिटी है। मुझे गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट से स्कॉलरशिप भी मिली, जिसकी वजह से मैं लंदन स्कूल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स से PhD भी करने गया। अच्छे एजुकेशन के अभाव में मैं वो काम नहीं कर पाता जो मैं आज कर रहा हूँ।
जब भी किसी माँ बाप को ये पता चलता है कि उनका बच्चा दृष्टिहीन पैदा हुआ है या आगे चलकर नहीं देख पाएगा, वो बहुत ही कठिन समय होता है। लेकिन विशाल के माँ बाप ने कुछ ऐसे डिसीजंस लिए कि विशाल का फ्यूचर सिक्योर होता है।
समाज में लोग इनडायरेक्टली ये जाहिर जरूर कर देते रहते कि मैं अपना जीवन एक्चुअली बिताऊंगा कैसे। बहुत सोचने के बाद मुझे लगा कि अगर इनका नज़रिया बदलना है तो मुझे इनकी सोच से कहीं आगे बढ़ना होगा। मैंने अपनी पढ़ाई आगे बढ़ाई, BCom करके CAT क्लियर किया और इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट IIM लखनऊ में MBA के लिए प्रवेश पाया। IIM लखनऊ में ह्यूमन रिसोर्स और मार्केटिंग में मैंने स्पेशलाइजेशन की। बहुत सी कंपनीज मुझे शॉर्टलिस्ट करती थी, जैसे ही अंदर घुसता था और पता नहीं उनको क्या हो जाता था, वो कहते हैं कि नहीं यार मेरे पास कॉलेज ही नहीं है। IIM लखनऊ में कैंपस प्लेसमेंट के दौरान टाटा मोटर्स उन कुछ ही कंपनीज में थी जिन्होंने सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस में पारदर्शिता दी। अगर तुम्हें कुछ करने का जज्बा है तो कोई रोक नहीं सकता, अपने कंफर्ट जोन से बाहर निकलिए। अगर आप हारना नहीं चाहते हो तो ठान लो कि आप कामयाब बन गए होंगे।
विशाल बहुत खुशकिस्मत है कि उनके माँ बाप ने उनकी पढ़ाई में कोई कमी नहीं छोड़ी। लेकिन कई माँ बाप ऐसा सोचते हैं कि दृष्टि बाधित बच्चे की पढ़ाई में पैसा और समय खर्च करना बेकार। जगदीश के साथ भी कुछ ऐसा ही हुआ, लेकिन जगदीश ने उन हालात से हार मानने की बजाय उन हालात को बदलने की ठान।
अगर किसी के पास स्ट्रॉन्ग विल पावर है या किसी की पॉजिटिविटी कंस्ट्रक्टिविटी है तो मेरे को नहीं लगता कि उसके फिजिकल चैलेंजेस कभी भी कहीं भी कोई आड़े आते। मेरे घर वालों ने मुझसे कहा तुम्हें पढ़ने की क्या जरूरत है, मैंने लगा क्यों मेरी बाकी लोग क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं, उनका वो बड़े होंगे काम करेंगे बिजनेस करेंगे तुम्हें रोटी तो खानी है, कितना तो तुम्हें मिल गया। तो जब ये वाली प्रॉब्लम समाज में आती है तब वो बड़ी कुरेदती है। और हमारे को क्योंकि सारी दिशाएं सुनाई देने की वजह से जो हमें हर्ट करने वाले कमेंट्स और रिमार्क्स होते हैं वो इतना हर्ट करते हैं कि या तो हम इतने नेगेटिव हो जाते हैं कि हम सोचने से सही कर लें और या इतने एग्रेसिव और चैलेंजिंग हो जाते हैं कि हम कुछ बन जाते हैं। तो मैं भी उन्हीं में से एक हूँ कि मुझे जिद आ गई कि मैं तुम्हें दूंगा तुमसे लूंगा नहीं।
जगदीश इस चीज से खुश नहीं था कि वो परिवार की दो रुपये वो कुछ करना चाहता और वो उसने करा।
मुझे लगता था कि एजुकेशन ही एक ऐसा मीन्स होगा कि जो मेरी अल्टीमेट एम्स को डिजायर्स को मुझे रिकॉग्नाइज सोसाइटी में कराएगा और मेरी फैमिली में मुझे स्टेटस दिलाएगा। मेरी आईएएस बनने की इच्छा थी और उस समय पर डिसेबिलिटीज को आईएएस में नहीं लिया जाता। जब मैं खुद आईएएस नहीं बन सकता था तो मैंने इतने सारे आईएएस प्रोड्यूस करे थे। आज मुझे लगता है कि मेरे पास 45,000 स्टूडेंट हैं तो मेरे 90,000 आंखें हैं।
आज की इन कहानियों से एक बात साफ है कि दृष्टिहीन लोग भी हमारे देश के मानव संसाधन यानी ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज का एक अहम हिस्सा बन सकते हैं। जरूरत है उनकी पढ़ाई और ट्रेनिंग में इन्वेस्ट करने की, निवेश करने की। उनको काम चलाओ नहीं, प्रोफेशनल और अच्छी क्वालिटी की एजुकेशन दिलवाने की ताकि आगे चलकर वो अपनी सलाहियतों के हिसाब से अपना प्रोफेशनल रोल चुन सके। दृष्टिहीन बच्चे से उम्मीद न रखना उसके सपने छीन लेने के बराबर है।
दृष्टिहीनता से जुड़ी जानकारी के लिए हमें ईमेल कीजिए। हमारा आईडी है
These are real people living in the real world doing real jobs. And I'd just like to share four more very, very quick stories before I move on to the next issue. I think the year was 2001. You know, my wife was planning a trip to the United States and we were looking for a cheap ticket. My travel agent said that Delhi, San Francisco, New York, Delhi ticket would cost me about 55,000 rupees, and I felt that was a little on the high side. So I checked out with somebody at the British Airways as to what might be the best way of getting a cheap ticket. And she introduced me to a travel agent in Noida. So I talked to this guy, his name was Sanjay Dang, and he said, give me 10 minutes, I'll get back to you. And 10 minutes later, he called me and said, we can give you a ticket for 40,000 rupees. If you don't mind traveling by South Korea, Asia Airlines. So we took the ticket, we went, my wife went, came back, and then we went to pay the bills. When we walked into our office in Sector 18, we suddenly discovered that this gentleman, Sanjay Dang, who had sold the ticket to us, was the owner of the company and he happened to be totally blind. And he told me that he had started this company in 1991 with just him and a runner boy. He built the business up over the years. Today he hires more than 45 people in his company, all sighted people. Two offices, one at Noida Sector 18, the other at World Trade Center in Connaught Place. His younger brother who graduated from college got a job with him. His younger sister also, who had graduated from college, got a job with him. And he is providing employment, he runs the business, and 99% of the clients who work with him, all of them have to talk to him at some point or the other because he is the ultimate walking encyclopedia when it comes to the travel business. And his turnover runs into crores, and he's been sustaining that business over the years. And so Sanjay Dang is a very clear example of entrepreneurship. In 1998, as when I was being introduced, the lady had mentioned that I was involved with the World Cup of Cricket for the Blind. So when we were working on this World Cup Cricket for the Blind, I get a call one day from a gentleman who said, look, I've been blind for the last 15 years. I met with an accident, I lost my eyesight. I lost my job at that point of time with an export company. I was supposed to get married in 2 weeks' time. That broke down. I've been sitting at home. And recently I saw this on ESPN that a World Cup of Cricket for the Blind was going to happen in New Delhi. Now, I am a cricket, like most Indians, I am a cricket fanatic, and I would like to be part of this thing if possible. So I asked him to come over and meet me. And when I met him, I realized that this guy was, very, very presentable sort of guy, good looking, spoke very well. And so I said, do one thing, pick up the telephone and start speaking to newspapers, telling them that this World Cup is going to happen in Delhi. So he did that for 2-3 weeks. When I found that he was doing a great job, I told him, let's have the next assignment, which is go to the schools and colleges in Delhi, talk to the in the assembly, talking about the World Cup of Cricket for the Blind. And he did that, the World Cup happened, and about 2 weeks after the World Cup, the public relations agency, which was handling our PR, came to me and said, Mr. Abraham, do you think we could give this blind gentleman a job? So I said, talk to him, if he's willing, go ahead. So he got the job, and 4 years later, in 2002, when I was organizing the second World Cup in Chennai, I called the same gentleman and said, look, we need PR help now. We are doing the second World Cup. He turns around and tells me, look, George, I have actually quit my job. So I said, what happened? He said, no, not to worry. I quit my job. I've set up my own company now. And I am going to handle your World Cup PR. And he did so. And it was a fabulous success. His name is Siddharth Sharma. And today, he's running this company called Foundations PR. He's got clients which are who are fashion designers. He's got exclusive furniture brands. He's got textile brands. He's got hotels. He's got a very good, interesting portfolio of clients. And he's doing extremely well. So being blind has not really stopped him. There's another lady who is today a grandmother, has 4 grandchildren, 2 children who are married, and this one. She lost her eyesight when she was 7 years old because of retinitis pigmentosa. And she stayed on in the school till class 8 when the principal said, we can't have her in the school. So she had to leave the school. And her parents said, let's learn sitar. So she started learning the sitar. But after 2 years, she asked her guru, do you think I will be able to play like Ravi Shankar? The guru smiled and said, lady, that will never happen because you don't have a ear for music. There is a misconception in India and probably the world over that anybody who is blind would be a good musician. The only musician worth the while who is blind in India is perhaps Ravindra Jain. We haven't heard of many others. So she quit her music and went on to do other things. To cut a long story short, today, she runs a company called Silver Line HR Consultancy. Silver Lining HR Consultancy. And she does training programs for corporates. She recruits people on behalf of corporates. She places people, not just blind people, all kinds of people. She places them. And interesting story is that her husband was working in a corporate house. When he saw the success of his wife's company, quit his job and joined her. And today, she travels the length and breadth of the country doing business. So she's doing extremely well. So the point is that when something like blindness has struck, these people whom we have seen on television, on the show, as well as the people I've talked about, chose not to stop. Instead, they chose to look for solutions, look for the way forward, found ways of moving forward. Now, you might wonder, it's one thing to say that we will hire a blind person or a blind person is going to do business, but how will they manage stuff? You know, on a day-to-day basis, there are so many transactions that you do. You have to read, you have to communicate, emails, presentations, and all that, you know. And business initially okay, dealing with a blind person is a novelty, but on an ongoing basis, it's not going to be fun if the blind person is not competent. So I'd like to show you a second video, which probably answers some of these questions. This is number 6.
टेक्नोलॉजी इज अ ग्रेट लेवलर, इसमें बहुत सी असमानताएं दूर करने की ताकत है, एजुकेशन, नौकरी, रोजमर्रा के छोटे छोटे काम, हर एरिया में जरा सी सूझबूझ और इजाद से दृष्टिहीन जनसंख्या की जिंदगी में बहुत बड़ा बदलाव आ सकता है। नजर या नजरिया में हर्ष ने खोज निकाली है कुछ ऐसी इजादें जिनमें असंभव को संभव बनाने की ताकत है।
इस एपिसोड के रिसर्च के दौरान मुझे एहसास हुआ कि हमारी इंडिपेंडेंस, आत्मनिर्भरता बहुत सी ऐसी चीजों पर टिकी है जिन्हें सिर्फ देख के समझा जा सकता है, और मैंने ऐसी टेक्नोलॉजीज की तलाश शुरू की जो इस लिमिटेशन को पार कर सके। और इस सिलसिले में हमने सबसे पहले ढूंढ निकाला दीपेंद्र मल्होत्रा जी, जिनकी मुहिम है कि टेक्नोलॉजी से जुड़ी इन आसानियों को ज्यादा से ज्यादा दृष्टिबाधित लोगों तक पहुंचाया जा सके।
टेक्नोलॉजी सॉल्यूशन सेंटर यहाँ पे है, तो उसमें हम लोग कई किस्म के एजर अप्लायंसेस और टेक्नोलॉजी सॉल्यूशंस मुहैया करा रहे हैं दृष्टिबाधित व्यक्तियों के लिए। जैसे कितना वजन है वो देखना है तो उसको हम लोग उसके थ्रू नाम सकते हैं। बाकी कैलकुलेटर्स हैं, ऐसे रीडिंग राइटिंग टूल्स, ब्रेल रीडिंग राइटिंग टूल्स बहुत सारे हैं।
शिक्षा मानव को बंधनों से मुक्त करती है।
Your blood pressure is classified as non-hypertension.
सक्षम की शुरुआत तो हुई 2003 में और खास तौर से टेक्नोलॉजी सॉल्यूशन यूनिट को लेकर के ही शुरू हुई। एक स्मार्ट केन हम लोग बोल रहे हैं जिसको सक्षम कोलैबोरेशन कर रहा है IIT और फिनिक्स सिस्टम चेन्नई के साथ में, जो कि एक इस व्हाइट केन के ऊपर ही अटैच हो जाएगी।
इसमें एक अल्ट्रासोनिक सेंसर लगा है जिससे आगे ग्रीन प्रोड्यूस होते हैं, जिससे डिटेक्शन होने के बाद वाइब्रेशंस के जरिए से इसमें इंडिकेशन।
दीपेंद्र जी के नाम को देख के हमें यह समझ में आया कि छोटे छोटे इनोवेशंस बहिष्कार या एक्सक्लूजन का तोड़ बन सकते हैं, बाधाओं को मिटा सकते हैं। और इसकी एक मिसाल हमें देखने के लिए टाटा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सोशल साइंसेस टिस्ट।
ए हमारा MK टाटा लर्निंग सेंटर फॉर रिसर्च इन मैथ, ए टाटा सब सोशल साइंसेस लाइब्रेरी के अंदर है। ये है सारा रीडर, इसकी मदद से हम जो कुछ प्रिंटेड मटेरियल्स को स्कैनिंग करके इंस्टेंट रीडिंग कर सकते हैं। ये बिना कंप्यूटर काम करता है। ये ओरका मैग्नीफाइंग सॉफ्टवेयर है, जो कुछ स्क्रीन में आता है सबको एक इनलार्ज करके देखता है। ये ब्रेल एम्बोसर एक कंप्यूटर के साथ अटैच हुआ है, किसी टेक्स्ट को हम ब्रेल में एम्बोस कर सकते हैं।
सस्ती टेक्नोलॉजी और कॉमन सेंस की मदद से कई मुश्किल कामों को आसान बनाया जा सकता है, और इसका एक जबरदस्त उदाहरण है बीना और प्रशांत, एक कपल जिन्होंने रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी में टेक्नोलॉजी की मदद से कई मजेदार सॉल्यूशंस निकाले।
हम टोटली लोगों को लगता है कि आप कैसे रहेंगे, दोनों लोग अगर है तो बहुत दिक्कतें आएंगी दोनों, और हम लोग यहाँ दोनों ही रहते हैं, हमारे साथ और कोई हेल्प नहीं है। डोमेस्टिक हेल्प जरूर है पर आना जाना है।
नेशनल एसोसिएशन फॉर द ब्लाइंड एनएबी में मैंने 5 महीने की कंप्यूटर ट्रेनिंग की। ट्रेनिंग कंप्लीट होने के बाद ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को ऐसा लगा कि मैं अब एक टीचर बन सकता हूँ, और उसी साल मैंने वहाँ पे एज ए कंप्यूटर ट्रेनर ज्वाइन कर लिया। और मैंने देखा कि टेक्नोलॉजी की मदद से मैंने अपनी रीडिंग राइटिंग की नीड पूरी कर ली है।
टेक्नोलॉजी का बहुत बड़ा रोल है, पिछले कुछ सालों में बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ चुका है। बहुत बार ऐसा हुआ जब मैं आती थी रिक्शा हो या ऑटो हो उन सबको लेकर के, तो एड्रेस बताने के बावजूद ऐसा होता था कि वो कहीं कहीं हमें उसी बिल्डिंग के आसपास कहीं कहीं और भटकाते थे। तो कॉल बेल लगाया हमने, वो रिमोट जो है वो मेरे पास होता है, उस कॉल बेल को यूज़ करके मुझे 100 मीटर की दूरी में उसे पता लग जाता है कि मैं अपने घर के आसपास हूँ। फिर उसको प्रेस करते करते मुझे अपना घर का जो टर्न है वो मुझे मालूम चल जाता है, फिर मैं आ जाती हूँ अपने घर पे।
मैंने अपना बैंक अकाउंट खोला और मैं ट्रांजेक्शन करने लगा, लेकिन उसमें कई प्रॉब्लम्स आती थी, डिपेंडेंट रहना पड़ता था। चेक्स इशू करने के लिए किसी साइटेड पर्सन से कहना होता था कि वो हमारे लिए चेक फिलअप कर दें और हमसे सिग्नेचर करवा लें। तो मैंने इसका एक सॉल्यूशन ढूंढा, मैंने कंप्यूटर पे एक चेक प्रिंटिंग टेम्पलेट बनाया, एक ऐसा छोटा सॉफ्टवेयर मॉड्यूल जिसे ब्लाइंड पर्सन टोटली इंडिपेंडेंटली इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं और अपने बैंक के चेक्स पे इंफॉर्मेशन प्रिंट कर सकते हैं।
बहुत बार हमें लगता है कि हमें चाय डालने में, चाय छानने या फिर पानी वानी डालने में पता नहीं लगेगा क्योंकि हम टच करके देख नहीं सकते। तो मेरे पास लिक्विड लेवल इंडिकेटर है, छोटी सी मशीन है जो कि आप कप में ग्लास में लगा दें और पानी या चाय डालना शुरू करेंगे तो उसको टच करेगा तो आवाज़ करता है, तब आपको ये मालूम चल जाता है कि आपका चाय या पानी जो आप डाल रहे हैं वो उससे आगे ना डालें। मुझे बहुत बार दिक्कत ये आती है कि कपड़ों का कलर पहचानने, बहुत सारे कपड़े हैं मेरे पास तो कलर्स भी बहुत है, तो उसमें क्या है ऑडियो लेबल लगा करके और आप रिकॉर्ड कर दें तो आपका वो कपड़ों का कलर अगली बार आप उसको टच कराएंगे तो बता देगा ये कौन से कलर का आपका कपड़ा है, आपने जो कुछ रिकॉर्ड किया है वो आपको बता देगा। नोटों की पहचान जो है मुझे समझता है कि बहुत ज़रूरी चीज़ है। मेरे पास एक रुपी चेकर है जिससे कि नोटों की पहचान करके मैं आसानी से लोगों को देना या करना हो सकता है।
आजकल टेक्नोलॉजी और सही ट्रेनिंग की मदद से नेत्रहीन भी किसी भी ऊंचाई तक पहुँच सकते हैं।
मेरे बचपन और आज की जिंदगी में जमीन आसमान का फर्क है। सेलफोन, इंटरनेट, ईमेल, उस जमाने में साइंस फिक्शन की बातें लगती थी और आज टेक्नोलॉजी ने यह तक मुमकिन कर दिया है कि एक दृष्टिहीन इंसान प्लेन उड़ा सकता है। माइल्स हिल्टन बाबर ने लंदन से सिडनी तक प्लेन उड़ाया और उसे सुरक्षित तरीके से लैंड भी कराया। यह है टेक्नोलॉजी का चमत्कार। बस जरूरत है इस टेक्नोलॉजी को अफोर्डेबल बनाने की और हर दृष्टिहीन इंसान तक पहुंचाने की और फिर देखिए द स्काई इज द लिमिट।
दृष्टिहीनता से जुड़ी जानकारी के लिए हमें ईमेल कीजिए। हमारा आईडी है
अ फ्यू इयर्स अगो माय वाइफ एंड आई वी हैड एक्चुअली गॉन टू गॉन फॉर अ मीटिंग टू समबडीज ऑफिस एंड वी वर हाफवे थ्रू द मीटिंग व्हेन आवर होस्ट सडनली रियलाइज्ड that he hadn't offered us tea or coffee. So suddenly he turns to my wife and says, Madam, what will your husband have? So she looked at me and then she looked at him and said, well, you'd have to ask him because he couldn't drink. He said, no, but what, coffee or tea? He said, ask him. So then he asked me, so I said, I'll have a coffee. Then he continued, he says, what is he going to have, sugar, with milk? So again, he said, look, you know, he wants to have different things on different days. Sometimes he has a bit sugar, without sugar, you have to find out what he wants to take. So this was one instance. Another instance was a friend of mine, Professor Bhaskar Y. Mehta, he was a professor of English. He was traveling from Ahmedabad to Delhi. He was totally blind. And the Indian Railways offers a 75% discount to train tickets for blind passengers. So when the ticket examiner came to check out, he produced his ticket and the medical certificate. He said, oh, so you're blind? So he said, yes, sir. And then he had a small conversation and then he stopped and said, you know, I think you are not blind. He said, no, I am blind. This is my medical certificate. So the TTR says, but you speak English. You know? There was another instance where you know, I took my graduation at St. Stephen's College, and I think it was after my third year exam, I had gone home and I had jaundice, and I had to be hospitalized. And a family friend turned up in the hospital. My father and my younger brother were in the room. So suddenly when he came, I noticed that whenever he spoke to me, he would raise his voice, and he would speak to me in Malayalam. While he spoke to my brother and father, he was speaking in a normal voice in English. So after a while, I was wondering why this is happening, and then I realized. So I put my hand up and I said, Uncle, one sec. He said, again in Malayalam, he asked me, what's the problem? So I said, the problem is that my problem is not with the ear. You don't have to shout. I don't understand Malayalam very well, so you'll have to speak to me also in English. And thirdly, the problem is with my eye, not with my ear or with my brain. So the point I'm trying to make here is very often we tend to look at what or emphasize on what people don't have rather than what people have. we tend to look at the glass which is half filled. Many of us, majority of people tend to get carried away by the half empty part of the glass. But few of us tend to look at the half filled part of the glass. And I think it is useful for us always to look at what we have rather than what we don't have. It's good for us to develop what we have rather than feel sad and sorry for what we don't have. And all these visually impaired people that we have seen are people who have developed their skills, their talents, their ability, their potential, and they have moved on in life, and they have achieved as well as anybody else in our world. But the people who tend to look at the half-empty part of the glass or look at what people don't have, they are the people who kind of stay back, don't move, don't progress. You know, there's an advertising company called Lintas, and you know, we produce a radio program called Aive Ye Hai Roshni Ka Darwa, and I was looking for sponsors who could fund the thing. So I thought it was a good idea for me to actually get in touch with Lintas and sort of see if they could help me market. So I spoke to a lady who was the chief. Appointment was fixed. I had to go to Gurgaon for the meeting. So the day I was going, the day before, I gave her a call and I said, "Madam, I'm going to be reaching your office by 10 o'clock in the morning. I'm not very familiar with your building. I have an eye problem. So what I will do is I'll give you a call when I reach there. It would be great if you can send somebody down and kind of help me get up, because Gurgaon buildings are massive with different wings. And you know, if you take the wrong turning, you could be lost and I may not reach on time." So I was a little concerned. So she said, "Oh, you got an eye problem." I said, "Yeah." He said, no, let me come to your office." "No, you don't." I said, "No, I can come." He said, no, I'll come." So the next day she came to my office. Now, again, I had no problem with her coming to my office. But she certainly had a problem, a misgiving of me reaching her office. She felt that maybe, being blind, I may not be able to handle the situation. Now, this is unfortunately the common reflection that exists in, the common perception that exists, you know, that people with vision impairment are lesser beings, lesser capabilities. And I find as an individual, in spite of the fact that I have a very impressive or a resume that looks pretty good, If I remove the word that I am not visually impaired, on an average it looks pretty good. But I find that I am on trial every day. Every day I have to prove myself. So that is something which reflects on the perception that exists. PricewaterhouseCoopers has a policy of hiring people with vision impairment. In fact, in one of our episodes, we have featured Mohammed Asif Iqbal, who's done his MBA from Symbiosis in Pune, and then he joined as a consultant there. Now, the HR director of PricewaterhouseCoopers came to my office one day, and she said, "Look, we have hired about 25 people with disability in our office. What is their future in our office?" And that's a very interesting question, because it's simple to hire people at the entry level. And many people hire out of sympathy, thinking that it is CSR, it's good CSR policy to hire people with disability, or what you might call differently abled people and so on. But do we actually think of their careers in the company when we actually hire them? So recently, a friend of mine, Pranay Gadodia, he joined Deutsche Bank in Bangalore. Deutsche Bank has taken a corporate policy globally to increase the hiring of people with disabilities. And my friend was hired to basically help them to kind of handle this hiring business. And within 2 weeks of him joining the company, he got back to the company saying that it is one thing to hire blind people, people on wheelchairs, people who have cerebral palsy, it's one thing to hire them. But the important question is, what is their career path within the organization? For a person to grow in our organization, they need to be able to MIS system in the organization accessible for blind people? Now, blind people read using screen reading software, as you saw on the content on the television program. Screen reading software does not read images, does not read certain kinds of files. So, are the company MIS, for instance, databases, financial accounting packages, are all these accessible? The reality is, if a person has talent, if he's potential to become a CEO of the company, he can become a CEO of the company only if he has access to every piece of information within the organization. If he's able to participate effectively in every activity of the that happens in the company, he needs to know, he needs to be able to get insights into everything. Which means it's not just about feeling good and hiring somebody. It's also about making sure that the working systems, the working processes, the equipment we use, everything has to be accessible. Now this lady from, when I told the PricewaterhouseCoopers lady that a disabled person one day can become the CEO of PwC, she said, look, a deaf person, how will he handle video conferences? So I said, then don't do video conferences, do something else. But find a way that is accessible. At the end of the day, video conferencing is not the important thing. It is about communication. How do you communicate? So look for solutions to communicate. So what I'd like to leave behind with you guys here today is that processes should not determine, the processes and the means should not become the important thing. At the end of the day, it is the end that matters. So whether I reach Delhi by road or by air or by walking or by running, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, the question is, will I reach Delhi? So it is about how we do things. The process should not be given too much influence. And the problem that keeps disabled people out is that we tend to be very rigid with our processes. There's a guy called Kartik Soni in Delhi. He studied at Delhi Public School. He wanted to do science and mathematics. And when I was a kid, I was refused science and mathematics on the ground that I will not be able to do practicals. He said, how will you pour acid from one glass to the other? How will you measure using a vernier caliper? I said, yeah, my eyesight, I will not be able to do it. So Kartik Soni was permitted to do so simply because the school was flexible. The school realized what is important is not being able to pour acid from one glass to the other. What is important was the knowledge whether when pouring sulfuric acid into a glass where there are iron filings, what is going to be the reaction? Does the boy know that? The pouring act can be done by somebody else. But surprise, surprise, most schools, most education institutes insist that the students do these things themselves. If a blind student can give directions step by step to a lab assistant to do the same thing, I don't see anything wrong with that. But that flexibility of changing to accommodate is missing. So I think that's the principle. I think you guys are tomorrow's corporate captains. You are tomorrow's industrialists. You are going to be tomorrow's entrepreneurs, and you're going to meet a lot of people in the workforce who would be disabled. And believe me, there is a lot of talent among disabled people. You need to be open-minded, willing to make changes, not being rigid, because it's about innovation. It's about being creative, keeping in mind the end solution in mind. So, keeping this in mind, I'd like to show you the last movie for the day. It's the Lucky Number 13.
क्षमता या अक्षमता को नापने का क्या पैमाना है? हमारे समाज में बच्चे, बूढ़े, पढ़े लिखे, अनपढ़, तंदुरुस्त, बीमार, दृष्टिहीन, सब तरह के लोग होते हैं, तो क्या इन सब की रोजमर्रा की जरूरत का ध्यान रखा जाए? जब आम इस्तेमाल की चीजें बिल्डिंग्स, हॉस्पिटल्स, गाड़ियां वगैरह के डिजाइन बनाए जाते हैं, क्या उद्योग और सरकार उनको भी पोटेंशियल कस्टमर्स या भावी उपभोक्ता की नजर से देखते हैं?
पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट सिस्टम या सार्वजनिक परिवहन कहते हैं कि हम सबकी सुविधा के लिए होते हैं, मगर ये देखकर लगता है कि बस का नंबर जानने की सुविधा सिर्फ उनको दी गई है जो पढ़े लिखे हैं और देख सकते हैं। साथ ही बस टिकट लेना भी एक बड़ा मसला है। कंडक्टर आपके पास नहीं आएगा, आपको कंडक्टर के पास चलकर जाना होगा। इस निर्भरता को खत्म करने के उपाय बहुत ही आसान है। पहले की तरह आवाज लगाने वाले कंडक्टर्स हर स्टॉप पे ऑडियो अनाउंसमेंट और कंडक्टर जो सीट पर जाकर टिकट काटे, फिर हमें सुपाई को नजरअंदाज क्यों करते हैं? यहां भी अगर कोई पढ़ना नहीं जानता या नंबर्स देख नहीं सकता, उसका लिफ्ट इस्तेमाल करना अच्छा खासा मुश्किल हो जाता है, खासतौर से तब जब लिफ्ट में कोई और नहीं है। आत्मनिर्भरता के साथ लिफ्ट इस्तेमाल करने के उपाय एकदम सरल है, स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड पैनल्स और रिकॉर्डेड अनाउंसमेंट्स।
हमारे पैसेंजर्स जो है हर टाइप के हैं और काफ़ी सिग्निफिकेंट संख्या जो है वो ऐसे लोग हैं जिनको कोई हैंडीकैप हो या कोई फिजिकली चैलेंज हो, तो इनके लिए हम खास करके हम काफ़ी कॉन्शियस थे कि इनके लिए स्पेशल फैसिलिटीज होनी चाहिए कि ये लोग मेट्रो में आराम से सफ़र कर सकें। तो इस विजन के साथ हमने डिसाइड किया कि एक यूनिवर्सल डिज़ाइन होना चाहिए जिसमें अगर कोई भी डिफरेंटली एबल्ड हो, जिसको कोई फिजिकली कोई प्रॉब्लम हो, जैसे कोई व्हीलचेयर बाउंड हो, जिसको देखने में प्रॉब्लम हो, कोई हियरिंग इम्पेयर्ड हो, तो अलग अलग डिसेबिलिटीज़ के साथ भी अगर लोग आए मेट्रो पे, उनको मेट्रो में ट्रैवल करने में कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होनी चाहिए, वो सुविधा हम इस तरीके का प्लान कर रहे थे। तो इस कॉन्सेप्ट के साथ हमने अलग अलग फिजिकली चैलेंज लोगों के लिए अलग अलग फैसिलिटीज प्रोवाइड किए। अगर कोई ब्लाइंड हो, नेत्रहीन कोई पर्सन हो जो देख नहीं पाता है, तो वहाँ से ही टैक्टाइल स्ट्रिप्स वो स्टार्ट हो जाएंगी, वो गाइड करेंगी उनको इनसाइड द सिस्टम। और ये टेक्टाइल स्ट्रिप्स बिल्कुल आपको टिकट काउंटर तक ले जाएगी, टिकट काउंटर से फिर आपको ऑटोमेटिक फेयर कलेक्शन गेट्स तक ले जाएगी और फिर ट्रेन तक ले जाएगी, और फिर जब आप ट्रेन से उतरेंगे उसके बाद भी आपको गाइड करेगी। और आप देख नहीं पाते हैं तो ट्रेन के जो अनाउंसमेंट्स हैं वो बहुत क्लियर अनाउंसमेंट्स हैं।
खान मार्केट स्टेशन, डोर्स विल ओपन ऑन द राइट, प्लीज माइंड द गैप।
हर स्टेशन पे एटलीस्ट एक एंट्रेंस के पास वी हैव अ लिफ्ट, जिसमें कोई व्हीलचेयर बाउंड आदमी है तो वो खुद भी लिफ्ट को ऑपरेट कर सकता है। वो लिफ्ट के स्विचेस हैं वो लो हाइट पे हैं और ब्रेक में भी हैं, सो जो ब्लाइंड पर्सन है वो खुद वो स्विच को ऑपरेट कर सकता है। हमारे यहाँ स्टेशन पे कस्टमर केयर काउंटर होता है, तो इस कस्टमर केयर काउंटर पर आप कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं और कस्टमर केयर काउंटर से हम एक आदमी स्पेशली डिप्यूट करेंगे, वी विल पुट अ पर्सन जो ऐसे पर्सन को एस्कॉर्ट करेगा थ्रू आउट हिज जर्नी, ट्रेन में भी एक्सपोर्ट करेगा और बिल्कुल सिस्टम के बाहर तक सी ऑफ करेगा।
देश में एक बहुत बड़ी संख्या दृष्टिहीनों की है और जिनको बैंकिंग की सुविधा नहीं मिलती है, इसके लिए RBI ने भी एक मापदंड बैंकों को दिया था कि दृष्टिहीनों के लिए एक्सेसिबल ATM बैंक्स लगाएं। तो आवश्यकता इस बात की थी कि एक ऐसा टॉकिंग ATM मॉडल बनाया जाए जिसमें सभी बैंक के कस्टमर्स जिसको यूज़ कर सकें दृष्टिहीन खातेदार। नेत्रहीन जो है वो सामान्य व्यक्ति की तरह ATM उपयोग नहीं कर सकते, तो उनके लिए इसमें विशेष वॉइस गाइडेंस की सुविधा है। अपने हेडफोन से उन्हें वॉइस गाइडेंस ATM मशीन देती है और उन्हें ट्रांजेक्शन पूरा करने में सहायता मिलती है। इसके अलावा ATM में ब्रेल लेबल्स हमारे लगे हुए हैं, वो दृष्टिहीन को मार्गदर्शन देते हैं कि कहाँ से पैसा लेना है, कहाँ कार्ड डालना है। तो ये एक सामान्य एटीएम होने के अलावा दृष्टिहीन के लिए एक अतिरिक्त सुविधा हमारे एटीएम्स में हमने दी है, जिसे हम टॉकिंग एटीएम कह रहे हैं।
पहले क्या होता था कि जब टॉकिंग एटीएम नहीं थे तो हमें बैंक पे जाना पड़ता था, वहाँ पर किससे फॉर्म भरवाना पड़ता था, फिर हमें पैसे निकाल सकते थे, मतलब इन द सेंस कि पूरा डिपेंडेंट थे हम किसी के ऊपर कि अगर हमें पैसे निकालने कुछ करने। अब टॉकिंग एटीएम है तो अब हम इस पे जाके इंडिविजुअली कुछ भी कर सकते हैं, मतलब हमें किसी के हेल्प लेने की जरूरत नहीं है। उसमें यह है कि ना ही हमारा पिन कोई देख सकता है, ना ही कोई सुन सकता है, क्योंकि हम हेडफोन लगाकर काम करते हैं। हम चाहे तो स्क्रीन ब्लैंक भी कर दे, स्क्रीन को अनहाइड भी कर दे, वहाँ पर कोई कुछ शो नहीं करेगा, वो फिर भी हम काम कर सकते हैं। सब कुछ अब इंडिविजुअल हो गया और विदाउट किसी पे डिपेंड हुए मैं अपना काम एटीएम बैंकिंग का जितना भी है वो एटीएम के थ्रू खुद कर सकता हूँ।
ये मीटर ने अभी कुछ बोला ना, क्या था, क्या बोला अभी?
ये मीटर चालू किया सर, बोल रहा था।
वाह, ये तो बहुत ही बढ़िया है
जी सर।
और चलते वक्त भी कुछ बोलेगा या एंड में कुछ बोलेगा?
हाँ सर, एंड होते ही बोलेगा, जब बिल निकलेगा उससे पहले, जैसा ऑफ करेंगे नीचे का
जी,
जब ऊपर आ जाएगा ऑप्शन तो फिर वो बोलेगा।
ठीक है, बहुत अच्छा है। काश यही सिस्टम हमारे ऑटो रिक्शाज और ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट टैक्सीज पे भी होता, क्योंकि हमें पता चलता कि व्हेन मीटर स्टार्ट कब एंड हो रहा है, तो हम लोग जैसे दृष्टिहीन लोग हैं उनके लिए कॉन्फिडेंस आता है कि मीटर सही चल रहा है। अबे कोई है? आइए सर बैठिए। अच्छा, आइए, आइए बैठिए। थैंक यू बेटा, आपका नाम क्या है?
मेरा नाम जयराम सर।
जयराम, खाने के लिए क्या होगा?
खाने वगैरह कोर्स मिलेंगे, स्टार्टर मिलेंगे,
मेन कोर्स,
मेन कोर्स में आपको बटर चिकन है, कबाब चिकन है, ढाबा चिकन है।
तो ये बटर चिकन कितने का है?
बटर चिकन आपका 430 का फुल है, 240 का हाफ सर, कबाब चिकन 430 का फुल है।
और यहाँ का फेमस
हेमर जो हमारा वार्ड फेमस शर्मा है,
बहुत सहता करो।
हाँ सर,
तीन प्लेट शर्मा,
हाँ तीन प्लेट
चिकन, चिकन शर्मा सर, और एक प्लेट तंदूरी चिकन,
एक तंदूरी चिकन।
कितना वक्त लगेगा?
अभी एक से दो मिनट लगेगा सर,
बहुत जल्दी जाओ। बोलने वाला मेनू कार्ड, ऑर्डर करने में कोई दिक्कत ही नहीं। काश हर रेस्टोरेंट में ऐसा ही होता है।
मजा आ गया बस। इसे कहते हैं यूनिवर्सल थिंकिंग।
यूनिवर्सल डिजाइन किसी शोशे का नाम नहीं, ये वो सच है जिससे हमारे रोजमर्रा के काम की चीजें, पॉलिसीज, ऑफिसेज, घर, शिक्षा प्रणाली, हॉस्पिटल्स, मॉल्स, किसी भी चीज को डिजाइन करते हो इस बात का ध्यान रखा जाए कि समाज के सभी लोग इसमें शामिल हो सके और आत्मसम्मान के साथ उनका इस्तेमाल कर सके।
दृष्टिहीनता से जुड़ी जानकारी के लिए हमें ईमेल कीजिए, हमारा आईडी है helpdesk@।
You know, in 1998 when we organized the first World Cup, we had a mascot and the mascot was a tiger cub. You know, and the thinking behind this tiger cub was, or the thinking behind this mascot was, that there is a tiger inside everybody. There is a tiger inside each of us sitting in this room. There's potential. There's potential in the blind person too. There's potential in the disabled person too. That's number one. The second thing which I think this afternoon's interaction or films and my communication should have brought home, hopefully, is that there are n number of possibilities. Everything is possible. Whether it's politics, whether it's bureaucracy, whether it is legal profession, HR, whatever, it's possible. It's about training, it's about education, it's about technology. And thirdly, I think the message was that we need to be flexible, not rigid. We need to be willing to innovate, bring about change to accommodate. And lastly, we need to have an approach which is universal. Our society, our family members, there is a diversity. Everybody has their own special needs. When we get down to designing, whether it is a plan, whether it is a program, a policy, a product, we need to realize that there are different kinds of people who would be our customer, our user, our consumer. Steve Jobs, when he brought about the iPhone, you know, the other day there was a friend of mine who called me up and said there's a retired professor who was his cousin sitting in front of him, feeling very, very upset that her life was coming to a standstill because she was rapidly losing her eyesight and she would not be able to do things that she could do, like reading, like traveling, giving lectures, and so on and so forth. So I said, she's come from the US? He said, yes. She must be having an iPhone. He said, yes. I said, take the iPhone, click on the accessibility features, play around with it, and let me know tomorrow. So the next day, first thing in the morning, I get a call from him, and he said, this is wow, because the iPhone helps her to read books, the iPhone helps her to make her appointments, GPS, and almost every function that she needed was there on a simple iPhone. So I said, if you also have a tablet instead, what's the tablet that Apple comes up with?
An iPad,
yeah. So if she has an iPad too, it'll be, as the Tata Sky people say, it'll be jingle-a-la. Steve Jobs actually had the vision of creating a series of products which was meant for every member of the community. And to my mind, this is a wonderful illustration of our way of thinking as we move on. So now I think I'll be prepared to try and attempt answering your questions.
Which you roll on the pitch.
Yeah.
So now, will it be able for you to have a normal game of cricket? Are there tools available or is there any development in that?
Yeah, game of cricket is forearm and with a ball, the red ball if it's in the daytime, a white ball if it's at night.
Yeah.
That is something which I don't think Mahendra Singh Dhoni would want to be. He would want to play with the black, the red and white ball. We ask him to play with a white plastic ball with ball bearings inside, he will not want to do that. So the answer of that, well, blind people and sighted people play the game of cricket on the same platform using the sighted game, I think the answer would be no, as of today. But in science fiction, it might be possible. Maybe 15, 20 years, as Naseer Saab said, what was in science fiction in the 1970s, today looks real. So that might happen, I don't rule that out. But as things stand today, we don't have the tools for blind people and sighted people to play a normal game of cricket, as we might call, which is the same game. Having said this, I would think that cricket, as played by Mahendra Singh Dhoni and company, is cricket. And cricket played by blind people is again cricket the blind way. So both are normal sport with similarities. One bowling is overarm, the other bowling is underarm. One is based on hand-ear coordination, the other is based on hand-eye coordination. And I think there's some way to go before they could merge, but I believe it might happen someday, but as of now, it doesn't look possible.
Okay.
Was that the question?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Sir? In the videos we saw many people, they had inspirations like they faced taunts, exclusion from the society.
Yeah.
What was your inspiration?
I think my inspiration was, number one, I think I had parents who were talking big. They kind of believed in me, they invested in me, gave me all the kinds of opportunities. They also did something very clever. They introduced me to various things right when I was very young. They gave me an interest in cricket by reading out cricket coverage from the newspaper. And as a child, I dreamt of being a fast bowler. Why a fast bowler? Because at that point of time, India did not have a fast bowler. Kapil Dev had not arrived at that point of time. And I had seen and read about the Indian batsmen, the English batsmen being terrorized by fast bowlers like Dennis Lilly, Jeff Thompson, Andy Roberts, Michael Holding and so on. So my dream was to do two things. Bowl as fast as I can and send the batsman either to the hospital or to the pavilion. But of course, when I discovered that I had a bad eyesight and I may not be able to play cricket, I had to shelve that dream. It was frustrating. But in 1989-90, when I saw the blind kids playing cricket, I had written somewhere that perhaps the World Cup cricket that happened in 98 was a result of the fast bowler that wasn't. It was that passion. Secondly, you know, as a kid, I remember in the early 1970s, late 1960s, I think it was around that time that the first superstar of the Indian cinema appeared on the scene, the Angry Young Man. And I was very, very, as a little boy, I was very, very carried away by the great Amitabh Bachchan. And I wanted to do something in the space, not of acting, but in the space of media, communication, that is. So that was another passion which evolved over the years. Thirdly, there is another passion which I shouldn't be talking about, but I mentioned it since you asked the question. I was very fascinated by the yodeling king, Kishore Kumar. And I wanted to be a great singer like him. So I would sing, but I did not progress, unfortunately, beyond the bathroom. And then I came to college, I would sing, I had a guitar, I would kind of strum and sing, and then suddenly the moment I opened my mouth, I would hear the voice, I want to keep quiet. Shut up, you know, those kind of things. And so that also was a passion. And that actually resulted in 2004 when I took the Indian blind cricket team to Pakistan. we had a little concert in Karachi. And at that concert, there was a blind girl who sang. And while coming back from Karachi, a friend and I, we were talking about this, because I said in my presentation that when a person becomes blind, immediately they say, Sangeet Sikhao. So if every, there are 40 million blind people in this country, if 40 million blind people have been taught music, where have all the singers gone? None of them on television. One or two of them at Bollywood. What about the rest? So we formed a company called Magic Touch Talent Management, and we started doing auditions, identifying singers who were blind, and we started doing concerts, and our dream is to try to groom them into becoming performers. But that project is still in a bit of a nascent stage. It's a little struggling at the moment, but that's this. So to answer your question, I think the answer would be three things. Number one, the faith and the investment of my parents in me. Number two, the passion that I had in specific areas of life. And number three, my own personal faith in the Almighty. Because I believe when you walk in faith, God walks with you and everything is possible. That's my personal belief. And that has enabled me to actually embark on journeys which many people, when I start at the station, think that this guy is an idiot going on a journey. But when I've actually covered some ground, then they realize, yeah, that's actually making sense now. So these are the three things I think which have kind of inspired me to actually do what I am doing today. And it has also encouraged me from time to time to reinvent myself. I started off with advertising. At that point of time, I took it because creativity, glamour, passion, that's what advertising to me was to start with. But when I started getting bored of it, I reinvented myself, got into the space where I'm working today. And now I'm on the verge of reinventing myself again in terms of traveling and speaking and writing, which I believe will take me to the next 10, 15 years, hopefully. So you need to, so I think that's the answer to your question.
Thank you, sir.
Talk to them when they were supposed to give help, when they were supposed to read out something. Now that cannot be the only point of contact. I think if you really are kind of enlightened and you are progressive, I think you need to look at visually impaired people as fellow human beings, potential friends, people with whom you can have relationships, and teammates, soulmates, and so on. So I think if you can do that, other things will follow. Was that
yes.
A good answer? Okay, you can, you can.
Providing us with this opportunity. We move forward in life today with an ounce more wisdom.